Hello everyone, I am Asima Biswal. Today I will discuss about meaning of Vyayam and function of Vyayam. If you like my video, please subscribe my channel Economic Tech. First, I will discuss about meaning of Vyayam. A bank is an institution which deals with money and credit. It accepts deposits from the public, makes the funds available to those who need them, and helps in the remittance of money from one place to another. In fact, a modern bank performs such a variety of functions that it is difficult to give a precise and general definition of it. It is because of this reason that different economists give different definitions of bank. Okay, according to Crowther, a bank collects money from those who have it, to spare, or who are saving it out of their incomes, and lends this money to those who require it. In other words of Finley, a bank is an establishment which makes to individuals such advances of money as may be required and safely made, and to which individuals entrust money when not required by them for use. Okay. In short, the terms of bank in modern times refers to an institution having the following features. First, it deals with money. It accepts deposits and advances loans. Second, it also deals with credit. It has the ability to create credit, that is, the ability to expand its liabilities and multiple of its reserves. Okay. Third, it is a commercial institution. It aims at earning profit. Fourth, it is a unique financial institution that creates demand deposits, which serves as a medium of exchange, and as a result, the bank manages the payment system of the country. Then I will discuss about functions of commercial bank or modern bank. In modern world, banks perform such a variety of functions that it is not possible to make an all-inclusive list of their functions and services. However, some basic functions performed by banks are discussed below. First, accepting deposits. Okay. The first important function of a bank is to accept deposits from those who can save but cannot profitably utilize this saving themselves. To attract savings from all sorts of individuals, banks maintain different types of accounts. First, fixed deposit account. Second, current deposit account. Third, saving deposit account. Fourth, recurring deposit account. Fifth, home safe account. Okay, first, I will tell about fixed deposit account. Money in these accounts is deposited for fixed period of time, say 1, 2, or 5 years, and cannot be withdrawn before the expiry of that period. Okay, the rate of interest on this account is higher than that on other types of deposits. The longer the period, the higher will be the rate of interest. Fixed deposits are also called time deposits or time liabilities. Second, current deposit account. These accounts are generally maintained by the traders and businessmen who have to make a number of payments every day. Okay, money from these accounts can be withdrawn in as many times and in as much amount as desired by the depositors. Third, saving deposit account. The aim of this account is to encourage and modern small saving of the public. Certain restrictions are imposed on the deposits regarding the number of withdrawals and the amount to be withdrawn in a given period. Fourth,
purpose recurring deposit account. The purpose of this account is to encourage regular saving by the public, particularly by the fixed income groups. Okay, generally money in these accounts is deposited in monthly installment for a fixed period and is repaid to the depositors along with interest on maturity. Fifth, Home Safe Account. Home Safe Account is another scheme aiming at promoting saving habits among the people. Under this scheme, a safe is supplied to the depositor to keep it at home and to put his small saving in it. Okay. Then second important concern of a commercial bank, advancing of loans. Advancing of loans. The second important concern of a bank is advancing of loans to the public. After keeping short-term cash reserves, the banks lend their deposits to the needy borrowers. Before advancing loans, the banks satisfy themselves about the credit worthiness of the borrowers. Various types of loans granted to other banks are discussed below. First, money at call, cash credit card offer that. Fourth, discounting of bills of exchange. Fifth, loans. First, I'll discuss about money at call. Such loans are very short period loans and can be called back by the bank at a very short notice of say 1 day to 14 days. These loans are generally made to other banks or financial institutions. Second, cash credit. It is a type of loans which is given to the borrower against his current assets, such as shares, stocks, bonds, etc. Such loans are not based on personal security. The bank opens the account of the name of the borrowers and allows him to withdraw borrowed money from time to time up to a certain limit as determined by value of his current assets. Interest is charged only on the amount actually withdrawn from the account. Third, overdraft. Sometimes the bank provides overdraft facilities to its customers through which they are allowed to withdraw more than their deposits. Interest is charged from the customers on the overdrawn amount. Fourth, discounting of bills of exchange. This is another popular type of lending by the modern bank. Through this period, a holder of a bill of exchange can get it discounted by the bank. In a bill of exchange, the debtor accepts the bill drawn upon him by the creditor, that is holder of the bill, and agrees to pay the amount mentioned on maturity after making some marginal deductions. Okay, the bank pays the values of the bill to the holder. When the bill of exchange matures, the bank gets its payment from the party which had accepted the bill. Thus, such a loan is self-liquidating. Fifth, term loans. These banks have also started advancing medium-term, long-term loans. The maturity period for such loans is more than 1 year. The amount sanctioned is either paid or credited to the account of the borrower. The interest is charged on the entire amount of the loan, and the loan is repaid either on maturity or in installment. Third important function of a commercial bank is credit creation. A unique function of the bank is to create credit. In fact, credit creation is the natural outcome of the process of advancing loan as adopted by the banks. When a bank advances a loan to its customers, it does not lend cash but opens as the amount in the borrower's name and credits the amount of loan to this account. Thus, whenever a bank grants a loan, it creates an equal amount of bank deposit. Creation of such deposits is called credit creation, which results in a net increase in the money stock of the economy. Fourth important function of commercial bank is promoting check system. Bank also render a very useful medium of exchange in the form of checks. Through a check, the depositor directs the bankers to make payment to the payee. Check is the most developed credit instrument in the money market. Five important function of commercial bank is agency function. Under agency function, there are seven types of agency function. First, remittance of funds. Second, collection and payment of credit instruments. Third, execution of standing orders. Fourth, purchasing and sale of securities. Fifth, collection of dividends on shares. Sixth, income tax consultancy. Seventh, acting as representative and cash correspondence. Okay. First, I will discuss about remittance of funds. Banks help the customers in transferring funds from one place to another through checks, drafts, etc. Second, collection and payment of credit instruments. Banks collect and pay various credit instruments like checks, bills of exchange, promissory notes, etc. Third, execution of standing orders. Banks execute the standing instructions of their customers for making various periodic payments. They pay subscription, rents, insurance, premium, etc. on behalf of the customers. For purchasing and sale of securities, banks undertake purchase and sale of various securities like shares, stocks, bonds, debentures, etc. on behalf of their customers. Banks neither give any advice to their customers regarding these investments nor levy any charge on them for their services. Fifth important function of a commercial bank or under agency function, collection of dividends on shares banks. Okay, so on shares banks collect dividends, interest on shares and debentures of their customers. Sixth, income tax consultancy. Banks may also employ income tax experts to prepare income tax returns for their customer and to help them to get refund income tax. Seventh, acting as trustee and executor. Banks preserve the will of their customers and execute them after their death. Okay. Eight, acting as representative and correspondence. Sometimes the bank acts as a representative and correspondence of their customers. Okay. Then sixth important function of a commercial bank, general utility function. Under general utility function, there is first locker facilities, second traveler's checks, third letters of credit, fourth collection of statistics, fifth under writing securities, sixth give checks, seventh acting of factory, eighth foreign exchange business. First, I will tell about locker facility. Banks provide locker facility to their customers. The customer can keep their valuable and important documents in these lockers for safe custody. Second, traveler's checks. Banks issue traveler's checks to help their customers to travel without the fear of theft or loss of money. Third, letter of credit. Letters of credit are issued by the banks to their customers, certifying their credit worthiness. Fourth, collection of statistics. Banks collect statistics, giving important information relating to industry, trade, and commerce, money, and banking. Fifth, underwriting securities. Banks underwrite the securities issued by the government, public, private bodies. Okay, sixth, give checks. Some banks issue checks of various denominations, say rupees 11, 21, 31, 51, 101, etc., to be issued on auspicious occasion. Seventh, acting as referee. Banks may be referred for seeking information regarding the financial position, business reputation, and respectability of their customers. Okay. A foreign exchange business, banks also deal in the business of foreign currencies. Again, they may finance foreign trade by discounting foreign bills of exchange. These are the functions of commercial banks or modern banks. Okay, thanks for watching.